Zabit Khan longs to escape from the vicious cycle of debt and poverty that has plagued him for the past decade. Khan, his wife, and their 9 young children are bonded laborers at a brick factory in Afghanistan's eastern Nangarhar province. Khan owes money to the factory's owner, and he and his family must work until his debts are paid off. That means 12 hours each day spent squatting in the dirt, making line after line of clay bricks.
نو بس د مجبوریت د خاطر هم دا بټۍ قبوله کړې ده چې کوټه نشته او د مجبوریت د خاطر دا خښت هم قبوله کړې ده او ځان ګرو کړی دی.
The Khans are not alone. Tens of thousands of Afghans are trapped by debts that keep them in perpetual poverty. It's a common situation at many of the brick kilns that dot the Afghan countryside. For the majority of the workers at the kilns, there is no escape. Workers who can't afford basic necessities borrow money from their employers, but the wages that they earn are barely enough to survive on, and not enough to pay off their debts. With each year, their debts grow and are passed on from parents to children. Khan's daughter Hamida, who is 8, longs to go to school, but she's also bound by her father's contract to work at the kiln. A UN-backed survey last year revealed that almost half of all brickmakers in Afghanistan are children under 14. While it's illegal for children to work long hours or do heavy labor, families like the Khans have little choice. Khan's 6-year-old son Asad says he and his siblings get sick and injured from the grueling work. Asad wants to become an engineer, but he acknowledges the family may never make it out of the factory. In return for their work, the Khans stay in a mud brick house where they have a few mattresses to sleep on, some blankets and running water. Khan is no longer able to work. He says his problems began some 20 years ago when his family fled from Afghanistan to Pakistan. While living in a refugee camp, he became ill and borrowed several thousand dollars from a local kiln owner to cover his medical costs. Khan began working at the brick factory, but his weekly earnings left barely any money to pay off his debt. And as his family grew, Khan was forced to borrow more to pay for food, medicine, and other basic needs for his children. 7 years ago, an Afghan kiln owner bought his contract, and the family moved back to Afghanistan. Khan's wife says the Afghan government must help them and improve economic conditions so they and thousands of other Afghans can escape the cycle of debt and poverty.
Thank you.